We have returned to base to pick up the Cherokee. Even in 5 or 6 knot winds, that Piper is being blown everywhere, so we'll try the Cherokee for this. I'm determined to land it there, land there on video, which I've done before. So let's go. Of course, this will get us there much faster and should be more stable on land. Stall speed with flaps. 15 knots, we have a slight tailwind of about 5 knots. We have the left, right, left squiggle to go, and we're there. Around the next corner, there's a slight rise, and that's it. So we get a little bit of attitude, put the flaps down. And putting the flaps down. Car beat, is it too late? Or somehow just run out of. Nope. That saved us. I'll be for as long as possible before we hit the ground. As soon as I put the flaps down, this happened. Okay, we've obviously got some crossover here. Oh, and exactly that is. I'm gonna put the controller to 0 flaps or full flaps. It touches the bottom, and if you go a little bit over, there is a reverse thrust on there, which would cut the throttle. I did turn that off. We'll check it as some I come back on. It's looking a lot straighter. The weight of the plane is not going to be thrown around so much. Let's put it down there. That's one way to finish the stop. This OrbX, due to a slight thing in the A2A aircraft with the FCUI PC, don't work if you put them full on. You have to have like 70-85%, and the swerve then stopped me. Wow, we actually landed it. Great. Check trim. Definitely went up. I'm gonna have flaps 1 selected. near back to base. So you really just run and go down the hill. Like a Mustang for a few seconds. Following the principle that too much yellow is bad, but we've only got 10 miles of it. I want to get back to base and try the Piper on the other airport. Because if anything, has an even narrower landing grid. Still, Cherokee will certainly some speed up if you need it now and again, particularly racing down valleys. I'm basically having some fun with it now. Piper's great, but I think I will make a point of flying it in much. Well, how can we get much better weather than four knots landing? I guess if you go to field, fine. It just doesn't like to strip any kind of crosswind whatsoever. I'm taking a break from using ATC on these extra trips. I mean, people would be stupid to fly on Twitter anyway, so we're probably the only one in the sky. Obviously proved wrong by somebody. After landing, I don't know if I'm going to check that button config to make sure this not configured to use revert thrust. Now we certainly have a interesting amount of wind. immense fun. Didn't get to use the Piper for that airport, but... Well, we did. We just didn't get a chance to land it. The Cherokee is good for it, though. Our backup bush plane. Gonna have to fix these rendering settings. In bad weather, it's just too jerky. I've got no idea what it is. Not actually a parking spot here, but it's my reserved place. To the flex down. Today, in what might be our last attempt at any kind of bad weather with the Piper Cub, we're going to head north to Martin's Bay Lodge. Another, according to this, 4 foot wide one way. It actually says 4 foot wide. No, hold on, sorry. 4 foot altitude. We don't have the advantage of lots of speed, so. The main thing we want to see is the landing. I'd like to see Heidi talk. It's not happening so far. Yeah, it's still stuttering on the lower graphics set. We need to tax away, we're just going to throw it in the air. Plenty of runway for this. But you need to head over those mountains. I don't think the climb rate of this cub will do that. So we're going to go a less direct route round the coast. There, you could get up there, but it can. Well, we need to gain some altitude. We don't need to gain some altitude. We stay at this sea level the whole way. This would be flying straight to. Target. No, and he doesn't feel with the confidence of it. No. Heidi, wake up. Fun. Silent. We had that. Calm. Nervous. Oh, I wonder if my radio battery was flat. Some reason before, and I could pick up randomly being flat, that would cause it not to start. We need to shake around a bit. Nervous, okay. I'm just going to deliberately throw the airplane around a little bit here. Just holding on to the plane. But there's no noise. There has to be some noise here, surely that's not the way.
that's the
Hardy Cat is nervous.
One of the main reasons I'd like to climb up this mountain and do a short, more direct approach is
the runway heading is up here, so we can actually see it. It's really hard to see this runway in the trees. So you're above it in a straight line.
Now we have the mist problem. So to avoid just flying up into zero visibility, I'm going to point the airplane to the ocean. The worst I can descend over clear water. Tempted to fly over there, so we've got
a very, very slow plane, so I mean that in a positive way. That's just nervous Heidi.
Try this way and we can always circle around. I've already said this airport is hard to find. In fact, the first time I landed there, I found it, circled and couldn't find it again. You see why. There's a little hut and a parking space and a road and a pretty narrow strip of trees. Slow as you may be, but still exciting to fly when you've got a tiny airport ahead of you. Keep saying airport. There's no way you could justify this as an airport. It seems, I mean, the altitude is 2,000 feet. It seems we're like about 5. But no, the moving map says 2,000 feet. There we probably almost is. I see a kind of a. Is that it? There it is. Wow, best view of it yet. There it probably is. It doesn't look anywhere near that big when you approach it. So we have to get down, but not too low that if it isn't it, we miss the actual it. That is indeed it. The flying over the mountain approach worked, so I'll remember that. You missed a beautiful beach flyover. But who cares? It's all about landing it. Winds don't seem to be too oppressive, but let's wait to see what accuracy. Let's see what Active Sky throws at us from near the ground. Sure which side I get the best view of. Get the crosswind in this direction. Crosswind now. Good, that'll suit us view-wise perfectly. Oh, please don't give me any wind now. It would be so nice not to have to deal with that on one landing. Usual last minute drift. We bounced. Actually held on. As close to panic as we're going to get, I guess. We'll not be taking off from here today. I'll say that for another day, because there's nowhere really to go.
in this plane other than back to Milford Sound. I think we've all seen, especially me, enough of Milford Sound right now to last a while. Beautiful as it is, the outside view so you can see where we are, but I'm not going to use that to tax it, it would be cheating. You read about the reviews and how interesting she makes it, and comments on your flying, which in my case will be useful, and then it doesn't work for some reason. Martin's Bay Lodge. And there's a little sailboat down there. Ready to turn in to park. Ready for when I do want to fly out again. Other time. I'm still not sure where to fly to. I guess takeoff and landing here is really your only option. Let's try not to block the taxiway here, everybody. Hey guys, great to be back.